21 on your Saturday morning, and flu season is here, and it is already starting out to be a deadly one here in Central Texas. Three people have died from the virus in Travis County. And taking a closer look this morning, when it comes to protecting yourself against the flu and colds, you know, we've heard advice from doctors about washing hands, not touching your face, and drinking plenty of water. But those so-called home remedies that claim to fight the flu or cold, we're going to talk about those this morning. And here with Baylor Scott and White is Dr. Candida Suffrage. And you've written an article about the flu, and you have firsthand experience because your son just made it through the flu.
That's right. It was quite scary. All of my kids are vaccinated, and we do all the vaccinations as recommended by CDC, and I recommend that to my patients. And my son is 22 months old, and he was vaccinated for the flu in October. Came down with a fever. We took him to see his primary care physician, Dr. Paul Berg. Went ahead and started him on Tamiflu, as we knew we had had some outbreaks, mm-hmm. and he recommended that. However, 3 days later, he really started decompensating and was breathing fast and feverish, and we actually took an ambulance to the hospital where he was for 3 days. He's doing great now, but it just brings it close to home how serious this infection can be.
Absolutely, because you're treating lots and lots of patients, and then to have it hit your own family.
Yeah, and we're seeing it in clinic. A lot of patients, you know, kids and adults coming down with the flu. Half of them, I would say, has had the flu shot, mm-hmm. just as we recommended. But, you know, our hope is that at least it's not quite as serious as it would have been had they not gotten the vaccine. And, of course, viruses mutate. So as it's mutating, the CDC and the WHO are keeping track of what the strains are that we need to vaccinate for next year. Mm-hmm. So we're going to push again next year for everyone to get the flu shot. And I'm still giving the vaccine in clinic now if people haven't had it.
Yeah.
And it's not too late.
Yeah, one of the issues that I think parents deal with, you have two other kids. And so when one child gets sick and comes down with the flu, how do you keep the other children away and care for them and keep yourself healthy at the same time?
That's a great question. It's really hard in a family, and especially with multi-generations living together, and you oftentimes will have older people in the home, mm-hmm. too. Our most vulnerable people are those over 65, children under the age of 5, and pregnant women. So it's just really important to try to keep them away from the virus. But to answer your question, you know, lots of hand washing. Certainly, if you have a baby at home, which I do, I have a 5-month-old as well. Don't let people hold the baby that have had a fever or sick, or have been around someone that's had a fever or has been mm-hmm. sick.
So, how did you know early on that this wasn't just a cold for your 22-month-old?
That is so hard to know. And as physicians, we know that there are so many viruses out there. Actually, Baylor Scott & White monitors all of the flu tests and viral tests that we do in all our clinics and hospitals. And we know that about half of the tests are showing positive for influenza, but then there's a lot of other viruses like enteroviruses and rhinoviruses. I mean, there's about 200. You can't know for sure. What's important is that you monitor symptoms. So certainly if you have a child or you yourself, you have a fever, especially if it's difficult to keep the fever under control with Tylenol, ibuprofen, if you have any concerning symptoms like feeling lethargic or just not acting yourself, your child's not acting themselves, use your gut feeling and take them to a physician. The sooner you can get on the antiviral medications we have, the better. They can help somewhat.
Mm-hmm. Should you even try any of those home remedies that people talk about, vitamin C, zinc, ginger, garlic, in addition to what you're getting from the pharmacy?
Sure. I think as long as you run it by your physician and make sure there's nothing harmful, we don't have strong data for a lot of the supplements that people use, but that doesn't mean that you shouldn't try it. And as you mentioned, drinking lots of fluid, and I think taking vitamins on a daily basis is a good idea. Mm-hmm. You get most of the vitamins you need from food, but, you know, if your diet doesn't include all the vegetables and fruits that you need, a supplemental vitamin's a good idea.
All right, Dr. Suffrage, great information and a firsthand account of someone mm-hmm. who has helped their child survive the flu this year. Thank you so
much. Thank you very much.
We're glad he has been doing a lot better.